Hi friends! Today is going to be my TBR takedown and haul for the month of February. If you are new here, the TBR takedown is a game that I'm playing trying to get my TBR way down from where it is currently. It's a mess. I started off the year with 197. I started off last month with 199. Went the wrong direction in January, but in February, I'm happy to report that it has went in the correct direction. So first, let's start with the haul portion of the video. The first book that I am hauling is going to be A Long Way Down by Jason Reynolds. This is the March and April pick for the Wheatberry YA Book Club, which is my local bookstore's book club. This book is written in verse, and it is about a character whose brother was killed due to gun violence, and essentially it's him deciding if he wants to take retribution, and it all takes place, I believe, in about 60 seconds in the elevator ride from the top to the bottom floor of the elevator, and essentially, like, on each floor a different ghost comes in and talks to him, and the story again is written through verse. As you can tell from the cover, it has won a lot of awards. I'm very excited to get to this. The next book that we have is Welcome to Lagos, and this is by, I have to turn around and read it because it's a rough one. I believe it's pronounced Chibundu Anuzo. Could be wrong. Probably wrong. This is the Wheatberry Fiction Book Club pick for March, so picked that up to read this with the book club. And I'm not 100% sure what this one is about, but I know it takes place in Nigeria. If you haven't seen me talk about the book club this year, she's picking a book each month that takes place in a different country. We went to Cuba, we've been to Australia, now we're going to Nigeria. Excited to read this one as well. It's a really interesting cover. It has a weird texture. It's a weird feel. I kind of like it. I'm going to be reading this via audio because I have been told that there is a character who has kind of a broken English, which for me can be kind of hard to read, A, because I'm dyslexic, but B, also it's just kind of hard to read. So I prefer to listen to those via audio so that I don't have to struggle over the words. And those are the two purchases that I had this month, which takes my total to 201, back above 200, which is a terrifying place to be. Now we're going to go through my reads for the month of February. As always, I will not be including a full review for any of these. I will link you to my wrap-up video, so if you want to know more of my thoughts on any of these, you can check them out there. These also don't all count towards coming off of the TBR because some of them are rereads and some of them are books that I didn't own to begin with, so they weren't actually on my physical TBR, but I just like to go through all of them here so that you're not going, I seen this book in your wrap-up video, but you didn't talk about it here. It helps me, it helps you, so just roll with it. So let's get to those. The first is The Tyrant's Tomb by Rick Riordan. This is the fourth book in the Trials of Apollo series. The Dry by Jane Harper. This is the first book in the Aaron Falk series. I then read Rafe by Rebecca Weatherspoon, which does not count, as I read that via an ebook. Get a Life, Chloe Brown by Talia Hibber. This is the first book in the Brown Sisters series. Tweet Cute by Emma Lord. A Madness So Discreet by Mindy McGinnis. The Bromance Book Club by Lissa K. Adams. This is the first book in the Bromance Book Club series. I then read Agnes Moore's Wild Ride by Alyssa Cole, which again does not count because I read that via an ebook. A Discovery of Witches by Deborah Harkness. I have a full discussion live show for this that I will link in the description box below, in case you're interested in that. And this is the first book in the All Souls trilogy. The Deep by River Solomon. Again, this does not count as I read it via an audiobook. A Semi-Definitive List of Worst Nightmares by Crystal Sutherland. This is a reread for me, so again, this does not count. I do have a full review video for this book as well, and I will link that below. Truly Devious by Maureen Johnson. This is the first book in the Truly Devious series. I also read this month The Vanishing Stare by Maureen Johnson. Neither of these count because they were both rereads that led me to The Hand on the Wall by Maureen Johnson. This is the third and final book in the Truly Devious series, and this does count because it was my first read. So that gives me 8 books that did count out of the however many that I read. I also have an unhaul this month, which I haven't done in a while, but it's just one book. It is The Book of Life by Deborah Harkness. This is the third book in the All Souls trilogy. I don't own the second book. I did not enjoy the first book enough to continue on with the series, so I'm just gonna go ahead and unhaul this as well as the first book wherever it's at in this pile over here. So we started at 199, we hauled 2 books, we read 8 that count, we're unhauling 1, that gives us a new total of 192 books, which is still in the 190s, but you know, I read a lot of books this month. I just didn't read a lot of books that counted, and I'm okay with that because I really wanted to reread the Truly Devious series. I really wanted to reread A Semi-Definitive List. I have a whole goal of rereads that I want to get to this year. I think that doing rereads is going to be a pretty important part for me this year, just because last year I didn't reread anything at all. And I really missed some of my favorites, and I'm not reading some of my usual rereads this year, which is interesting. I typically always reread Harry Potter or something from the Shadowhunter series, so I'm rereading different things this year. That is all I have for today. If you have any questions about any of the books that I read, again, make sure you check out the wrap-up video or any full review videos that I have linked for you down below. If you have any comments, questions, or concerns, please address those in the comments section below. If you want to chat about anything, let's do that. That's why we're here. I post reading, writing, book, and planner related videos on Mondays, Wednesdays, and bonus videos on the weekends. So if you don't want to miss anything I have going on in the future, make sure you subscribe. And until then, I will see you guys next time. Bye!